All right, well, they say that people talking to their plants makes them grow better. And it's late at night, so the grow light is off, so being here doesn't exactly mean my plants are missing anything, and we're about to play a Plants vs. Zombies game, so I brought some plants here to play with me, like we sometimes do. I just gotta move, like, my 3D printed stuff. No one cares about that. Let's get some plants here instead. Move this controller. I brought one of my apple trees. I brought one of my hascaps. Whoa. All these things I'm growing from seed. I brought one of my Creole tomatoes that mad lad Guzma brought me. Hold on, I gotta sign into Origin here. Who's the Carmonia? Password is password 123456789. Yep, sign me in there. Or not. Okay, maybe it's an old password. Maybe not. Maybe it's an even older password. I think it's that. Wow, okay. 15-year-old apple tree? 15-year-old? How what? I don't have any 15-year-old apple trees. I have some 10-plus-year-old tomatoes. It's a bird, it's a plane, it's acoustic harmonica. We use cookies and similar technologies. Meh. Hold on. Where's my game library? What games do I have in my game library? I actually have more games in my game library than I thought here. I must have gotten them like with oh, these must be like free things I got with Twitch Prime stuff. So it's like, yeah, here's my favorites, all the Plants vs. Zombies things. And then it looks like I actually have a lot of Battlefield titles. I've Dragon Age Inquisition. Some Needs for Speed games. I have this on here. I'm pretty sure I bought it on Steam as well. I just guess I just own it twice. Does anyone even still play this game? Let's find out. We ended up chatting about it as we were wrapping up Mario versus Donkey Kong. So I'm gonna play it now because now I want to do it. You're off to eat lunch. See you later, Harmonia chat. Take care. Okie doke. Take care there, Azzy. Enjoy the 10-minute timeout that you redeemed. All right. I need to set game capture to PVZ Garden Warfare. Oh my god, that's loud. Oh, it's been a long time since I've seen this. Yeah, allow access, but go into my volume mixer and turn this down because holy crap is that loud. I have not seen this in a long, long time. Holy crap. Let's see here. Okay. Is anyone still playing this game? I forget. That is a lot of coins that are up there. I know I maxed out this game back when I played it. Rank 313, and that's the thing that would get you like the unicorn chomper in Garden Warfare 2. And I honestly kind of forget if I just went like really hard on this game playing it and played it like so much past rank 313, or if I got really tired of trying to reach that and really wanted the unicorn chomper and just used cheaty peach strats considering that coin count. Just for like a cosmetic alt thingamabob in Garden Warfare 2. I don't remember. But that seems like a pretty high coin count. Still can't believe the general guy joined your server. Is that what it said down there for a hot second? Anyway, the plants that I've brought to play with me today are my red apple tree. So I'm growing several apple trees from seed. This is one of the ones that came from a red fleshed apple that I have no idea what it is. And this is the one that develops like semi-red leaves at the top that slowly turn green. Oh, okay. In the Discord server, nice, general guy is here. So, yeah, that's cool there. This is one of my seed-grown hascaps that I got the seeds of from a farm last summer, and it's going a little bit crazy here with its branches. The other big one that I have is up to about this height too, but it's losing most of its leaves here, while making like a bazillion branches at the center. This one's making just a handful of really crazy branches, and my other one is making like a bazillion shorter branches is the case. And that's the one that I brought in the past to play video games here, so I'm taking this one instead. And then the last plant that's playing games with me here today is this Creole tomato, which if I switch to the thingamabob here, that mad lad Guzma, when he was visiting me here from Louisiana, he brought me some seeds from some things, like some okra, some cayenne peppers, and some Creole tomatoes, which are a type of tomato that's grown there in Louisiana. And I had 8 seeds. I planted all 8, and all 8 of them sprouted. But I think they don't like the dryness here. If they're from Louisiana, that means that they are meant to thrive in a warm and humid climate. This is a cold and dry climate. So literally all of them, except for 2, has died. Like, they literally just wilted at the top and then, like, started drying up and falling over and dying. So I don't know what I can do about that. I've been spraying these guys down to try and save them. This guy looks okay. The other guy has a branch that just looks like this, where it's droopy and not so great looking. But this guy, he's doing okay and he's getting new growth and stuff like that, and I hope it lives. So if they live and they make some tomatoes, I'll cross them with some of my other tomatoes and make some Creole Canadian hybrids and hopefully not have all them be dying immediately next year by growing some hybrids instead that might be a little bit more okay with this climate. So yeah, I want to bring that guy to make sure that it lives and stuff like that so I can make those hybrids, because yeah, most of my Creole tomatoes have been dying, but this guy's been pushing through. I have a little bit over 10-year-old tomatoes. I don't have any in, like, any small pots like that. I did start a batch of, these tomato seeds that were labeled 2013 yellow tomato, because I had the space and I didn't think any would grow, and then, like, 40 came up. So most of them are in that other room there, and most of them are pretty small, still about the same size as this, honestly, most of them. I have a whole bunch of those in the other room, but nah, this is one of the ones that Guzma nerd brought me from like a brand new packet of seeds and stuff. So more recent stuff, but just not so used to this climate. But the yellow ones seem to be doing good. I'm slowly taking them into work to make more space here, because I'm literally running out of plant space and stuff here. So, and all of my yellow ones are in like really big pots like that, because I wanted to have it be their final pot size before they go into the ground. So I never have to worry about upping the size of their pot before May when they go on the ground. I'm gonna turn this slightly because I'm kind of bonking my chair against it. Yeah, that I think that would be really cool. And I'm definitely gonna be saving some seeds from those plants. The fact that they were in seeds that were 10 and a half years old and they still sprouted is amazing. And because I have 40 of them, I'm gonna have a lot to give away. So yeah, I'll give away a whole bunch of those and tell the story of how they came from 10-year-old seeds. But yeah, so we were wrapping up Mario vs. Donkey Kong just earlier this stream, and we ended up talking about the way that Plants vs. Zombies has been going, and how that's not really super great, but ended up talking about Garden Warfare, and how there was a time that I was really addicted to this game. I did a full playthrough of Battle for Neighborville on the channel. I think I played Garden Warfare 2 once on the channel, like when I was really into it was way before I started as a content creator. But I put a lot of time into this game. I wonder if on Origin it says like my hours. I'm curious. Will it? Because I'd honestly like to know. Hours played 123 hours. That's not as much as I thought it would be. But yeah, 40 out of the hundreds that you group, one of different tomato types. I have those 2013 yellow ones. I have some Creole ones if they make it here. I have some Germany kinds. I have some cherry tomatoes from here locally. I think they're called Indigo Rose tomatoes. They're a type of black tomato. I have some Lollibom tomatoes, which are kind of yellowish orangish type. I'm growing some beefsteak tomatoes because unlike all the other ones that are smaller cherry tomatoes, they're like bigger kinds. So I want to cross them with the Creole here because the Creole are bigger kinds of tomatoes. And I have a mystery tomato that was growing in my mom's potted basil plant. I don't know how a tomato seed got there. I don't know what variety it is. But I have a mystery tomato. Oh yeah, I got you there. Yeah, I don't know how many were in that baggie. I should have taken a picture of the baggie before I dumped them in. I thought none of them would come up. I thought maybe one or two would at the most, and then it was just like 40. But there was probably like 50-ish or something in that bag, if I had to guess. It wasn't like hundreds. But anyway, we started talking about this game, or about Plants vs. Zombies stuff in general, and I talked about how I used to spend a lot of time in this game, and this was my favorite one. Man, its UI is so much different than the more recent ones. No. Not Garden Ops. Multiplayer. The main thing for Bob was Gardens and Graveyards. I'm honestly just curious about doing like this one-off kind of session late at night. One, because I felt like playing this game after that conversation. And two, I'm kind of curious if anyone's even still playing this game. Which there might not be. I might have... Okay. How many people are here? I think I played like 2/3 of this game with controller. And I played like 1/3 of mouse and keyboard. I tried to get into mouse and keyboard, but I was a lot more used to playing controller. I know I can aim better with mouse and keyboard, so I'm gonna try playing with mouse and keyboard. But yeah. Maybe, but I did transplant them to different pots. Like, once a bunch started coming up, I did transplant them to their own pots. I don't have enough space to give them all their own pots right now. So there's currently two big pots like that have 7 in there, and then there's one pot that has 4. And once I make space by bringing more into work, I'll give them their own pots and stuff like that. There he is! Here's my guy! Look at him go. Oh, and we're right at the end here. The Camo Ranger was my main on the zombies. I loved playing the Camo Ranger back in the day. And I missed the teleporter. I'm actually really dumb. But yeah, I already gave a whole bunch of them their own pots and stuff. My mouse sensitivity feels off. I'm gonna adjust it here. That's better. Man, it's been a long time since I played this game. That's dead. So people are still playing this game. It seems like. Oh, I can't go up there. Whoa, this is a full lobby. Holy crap. Hey, there's some other, like, max ranks in there. I don't think we're winning this. That's dead. That's dead. I'm dead. Yeah, they've got this held down. So people are still playing this game. Wow. I'm kind of surprised, honestly. And when we were discussing this in the, little thing where Bob with Mario versus Donkey Kong there, another one of my favorite parts of Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 1 and 2 is, like, the fact that there's basically two objectives to capture and hold down each map. Oh, yeah, you can still control on this screen if you see where you are and stuff. Oh, there I am, briefly. So, the Engineer class, in the first game, it was always the zombies attacking, always the plants defending. They changed that in the second game to make it so that, wow, I get a whole bunch of coins, even though I barely did anything. And then the next round takes a little while, there is the case. But you can go to the sticker shop meanwhile. Whoa, I really adjusted my mouse sensitivity, holy crap. The Legends of the Lawn Pack, whoa, let's get one. Anyway, I keep on distracting myself. But there's two objectives to get. So within just the context of the first Garden Warfare game here, there's four classes on both sides. On the zombies side, there's the football player or the sports dudo. It changes the sport depending on the variant. There's the engineer, there's the foot soldier, and there's the scientist who's like the healer slash shotgun close range kind of guy. The foot soldier is like the assault class, like rapid fire kind of assault rifle spray, unless you're playing the camo ranger like me, where every individual click is a shot, is the case. That's like the exception to that norm, so I like playing the gamma ranger. Sure, I get a whole bunch of consumable dudos, I guess. And what the engineer can do is he can set up a teleporter. So there's no running in this game. I don't remember if there was in Garden Warfare 2. There is running in Battle for Neighborville to go a whole lot faster, but there's no run button in this game. If you want to go faster, then you can play as the pea shooter and use the going faster ability there, or you can play as the engineer and have like the jackhammer ability there, which makes you go faster. So when you respawn and you need to go back to like the objective that you need to capture, it takes a little while, but there's a teleporter close to where the actual main objective is that, who would I used to play here the most, I wonder? Yeah, I'll play a cactus, I don't know. What would have been my go-to? It's been forever, maybe the future cactus. Might have been the camo cactus as well, playing the camo with both. I don't even have any customizable stuff on the citrus cactus, it doesn't seem like. I used to play a vampire flower a little bit in Garden Warfare 2, I remember. Don't remember if there was any specific one that I played here. I'm playing the camo cactus. Boss mode? Is that... What the heck is boss mode? What does it mean there? So on this map, for example, the point is here. Where if an engineer makes it here, they can build that up, and then the zombies can... Whoa. Can just teleport from where they respawn to that point there. So, in addition to wanting to capture the main point, the zombies would also want to capture the teleporter point. And the plants, in addition to capturing the, or defending this point, they'd also want to capture the teleporter point, or defend the teleporter point, or destroy a teleporter if it's already been made to prevent that, from happening, because of how long it takes the zombies to get over here normally is a big difference compared to the oi, dang it, dead, and now I'm dead too. So it's like Cheeto's cheetah skin, maybe. Okay, people are dying, people are dropping like flies here. But yeah, so you don't really have that in Battle for Neighborville, where there's just one objective to push. I guess they figured because they have like 10 plus classes on each side at that point, that they're not going to bother with forcing one player to essentially, what the heck? To go into that class, or else you just can't make the teleporter. So I guess that makes sense. But that was one of the things I really liked about Garden Warfare 1 and 2, is that there was two objectives to keep an eye on. And that keeps you a little bit more on your toes as well. Like, there's the engineer. Here's his drone. But yeah, my very slow rate of fire, but very strong hits here make it really difficult to hit stuff like that. Could switch to something like pea shooter, but yeah, I remember enjoying playing some snippy sniping classes, but yeah, no run button. I just gotta, oh yeah, I should put some potato mines down on the thingamabob. I gotta remember that. But yeah, the cactus is the sniper class here, is what it is. I think my taunts are blocking this here. I'm going over here. Whoops. Alright, well, I apparently killed that guy. Or someone, at least. And all their summons are in here now. Yeah, I should put some potato mines in the thingamabobs. The best place to put potato mines is on the other side of the Tallets. It looks like they do have the teleporter online. So they jump over it, thinking that there's nothing there, and then it's like, surprise! Let's kill this guy again. I killed someone. It wasn't the guy that I was looking for. But yeah, this character is not very good at close range. So the cactus is your sniper in this game. The sunflower is the healer. Oh, I think someone might have been about to revive me there, but that's fine. Whoops, that isn't where I wanted to go. I love the tune here. Whoa! I'm surprised that people are still playing this game, honestly. That's pretty cool. There, set up. And then maybe they'll jump over that and then immediately die. So the teleporter is over there somewhere on this map, I remember. So relaxing, man. Do you mind? Like, maybe not. I'm fairly certain that in Battle for Neighborville, you can fully heal, like, auto-recover on your own. Oh, I killed a basic zombie with my potato mine. Not a player, though. But in this, you can only recover to half health. Unless the sunflower heals you. Medic, come on, Doc! That's right! There's just so many classes in the later games that they tried to tinker it so that anyone can play anything and be having fun rather than forcing like a synergy of different classes and stuff. Oh, you got up here. I could also switch to Chomper. That might be fun. Chomper's fun in that you can one-shot zombies if you get close and nom them. Oh, nice headshot. Who else is sniping me? Oh, up there. I'm gonna switch my Chomper, I think, for now. And the zombies in this game don't actually have, like, a sniping character. The closest equivalent is the Camo Ranger. I think I like to play the Hot Rod Chomper, I think. Count Chompula, or that one. Jester Chomper, yeah. Chomp thing. I'm gonna play the Hot Rod Chomper. I think Hot Rod or Count Chompula were my go-tos. Count Chompula is like the vampire kind of variant where it's like if you get a kill, you'll recover some health, which can be really good for an in-your-face kind of character like Chomper. But the Hot Rod Chomper gets a speed boost when he eats a zombie as well. And after he's eating a zombie and chewing them is when he's usually really slow and vulnerable. So being able to Hot Rod out of there is handy. And you have like a normal ranged attack in the later games, but in this one, you just have the chomp. Plus, like, the one ability to shoot. Blarg. That goes, like, nowhere. No, how about you don't, actually? Oi. That isn't who I wanted to kill. But yeah, there's everyone out here that's like, while you've been streaming a bazillion different games, we've been honing the Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare 1. People are seeming good. You gotta jump? Yep, bait it out. And now you land, and now you're screwed. Time to die. Oh, someone saved the brain that moment! All right, I changed my mind. Camo cactus. You can use these barriers to kind of get up on places, too, sometimes. Dang it. I'm so bad at video games, I actually don't know what to tell you. Oh, I got a hit. That guy's dead. So I got an assist. Yeah, I think the zombies are kind of gonna sweep this time. This is what it's seeming like. Is there anyone actually over there? There's a heal thing. I see you sneaking around. Dead. So, oh. Didn't even see exactly where they were. Defend the estate! Well, got an assist there at least. Better respawn now so I go to the next objective. Okay. And then... let's see here. Time to form some walls! And put down some mines where they hopefully won't expect them. Let's sneak some in some places, like behind the boat. Alright, now I want up there. That is typically where you want to be, is a cactus. Alright, that guy's chilling with his garlic drone. I could do that, but meh. The heck? Whoa, I ran out of mousepad space. My keyboard hit was in the way there. I forget. Can I get up here on this map? No, I don't think so. I just put that down there for no reason. Whoa. Dang. Come on. Dang it. Couldn't get out of there fast enough. This guy might revive me, though. Never mind. He's outie. Is no one reviving this game anymore? Does that not happen? I wonder. Okay, let's see here. Let's see here. So, dead. Reload, please. Dang. Where the heck even are they? Whoops, that's not the revive button. I was pressing R instead of E. There's a trick in this game where you could just, like, be jumping. Like, you can't normally move when you're reviving, but if you just jump as you're moving across and you revive, you keep your momentum, and you can keep on jumping that way while you revive. I don't think that's a thing in the later games. Yeah, it honestly is. But I remember putting a lot of time into this game and having a lot of fun with it. Sneak this behind here, and then do you mind? I'm getting set up here. And then there's a way into this tower, I remember. If they capture this objective, then it's time for the final objective, Dave's mansion there. Okay, so I'm a little bit of a sitting duck here. Wow, really? I don't even know where the heck. Dead. Well, yeah, and these are like the summons that you can expend. Come on, I keep on pressing R to revive and it keeps on not doing anything. Alright, thank you, good sir. And the fact that this became three games. Oh, he uses teleport. Nope. Jeez, man. Well, my health is low. May as well just... well, never mind. Yeah, I knew that was gonna happen. This is online here. There's no campaign in this game. There does not exist one. Let's see here. I can't see crap! Imagine, though. I got that. How am I not hitting him? What? Okay, well, now it's a final objective. I'm sure not. So we ended up randomly chatting about this game, and then I was like, I think it's still on my computer. I wonder if people are still playing. And the answer is yes. How's it going today? Nevermore. Welcome to Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare here. I'm actually so bad at this video game, I don't know what to tell you. The Cheetos healing thing. I've been found. But yeah, is there in the later games? Yes. I really like the campaign in Battle for Neighborville. I think it's really fun. It's Mario versus Donkey Kong? Ass. Okay, this way we go. This isn't a way that you can go that's just where the zombies go to enter the mansion, so they need to get 5 in to win. Which is why you want to set up here as much as you can, because this is the easiest one to get into. So you just want to set up as much crap here as you can. Come on. Oh, I don't have any more there. Okay. And the teleporter is over there on this one. That's the case. Can I take out that shield? I would prefer to be up above. I just kind of wanted to set up there. Yeah, you are not rushing your way through here. Good sir. Those guys will handle the teleporter, I think. Or I can always use my garlic drone if I want to try and deal with the teleporter. Let's go back here. Let's put a plant here. Come on, there we go. Looks like they might have the teleporter. There's a lot of stuff going on there. Dang it, they got me. He knows I'm trying to snipe him, I think. Is Jover? Maybe. They have 2 minutes to try and get into here. Okay. Whoa, someone's freezing me. I can set up some things here, too. Because this is a way that they can go. Okay. One got in. Got him. That guy's already dead. My reload doesn't always work immediately when I hit it. Damn. Okay, I'm on fire now. Another one got in. They have another minute. We might still do it. Thought I saw a dude over there. They just need one more now. I think it's basically Jover now. Set that up there. Yeah, they got it. This is a loss. Alright, but now I'll be up above here. No medic. I'm gonna jump off this balcony in the cutscene. Oh, well. But yeah, that's this game in a nutshell. And this is the main game mode. There are other game modes, like there's the first to vanquish 50. I forget what it's called. But the main game mode was always gardens and graveyards here, which is just like the zombies are attacking, the plants are defending. In the second game in this series, they did make it so it's like either or. Like there are some that the plants are attacking and the zombies are defending. Sure, all the things, but this game was always this. There's also the PvE mode, which is Garden Ops, where it's like up to 4 players playing plants defend against like AI zombies in waves for like a thing that would be more similar to the original Plants vs. Zombies games of like, here's AI zombies pushing and you have to defend, but it's a shooter kind of thing. And 2 also changed it up and like, now there's a zombie defense mode and stuff like that. Yeah, basically gambling here, and then you get like the consumables that you can use in battle and stuff like that, or stickers that give you progress towards variants. I don't think that there's any microtransactions in the game. I don't think that there's any in the later ones either. Okay, I got 10 vanquishes with my little snippety snipe and stuff there.